In this video, we will learn how to use the PolySolid tool. With the PolySolid tool, you can create solid walls with a certain width and height. The PolySolid tool works similarly to the PolyLine tool, but contrary to the PolyLine tool, it creates solid objects directly. To get a better picture of what PolySolid really does, let's move on to a few examples. You can find the PolySolid tool in the Modeling panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type PolySolid in the command line and press Enter. Either way, once the tool is active, I need to specify a starting point. Before I do that, though, I should define the height and width of the solids I'm about to create. So first, I will select the height option that appears in the command line. I will type 4 and press Enter to specify the PolySolid's height. Then, I will select the width option to specify the PolySolid's width. So I will type 0.25 and press Enter. After specifying both the height and the width, I can click to define the first point. I will continue clicking to trace the polyline and create 4 walls. Notice that once I reach the fourth corner, the last part of the PolySolid object isn't created. To close the PolySolid, I will select the Close option that appears in the command line. In the next example, I will show you how you can create a PolySolid just by selecting a polyline object. So I will activate the PolySolid tool again. Notice that the settings I made in the previous example appear at the top of the command line. In case I want to change the height and width of the PolySolid, I can do so by selecting the height and width options respectively. To create a PolySolid that uses a polyline as a path, I will select the object option that appears in the command line, and then I will select the polyline object. Once I select it, the PolySolid is automatically created. At this point, I will activate the PolySolid tool once again to show you how to create the same object by tracing the polyline instead of selecting it. Without changing the settings, I will click to specify the starting point, and then I will click again to define the second point too. However, the next point will define an arc, so before I continue, I have to select the arc option that appears in the command line. The arc options are exactly the same as PolyLine's arc options. In this example, I will select the second point option and click on the midpoint of the arc to define the second point, and then I will click on the endpoint of the arc. To return to creating linear segments, I will select the line option and continue clicking on the endpoints. Then, I will enable Arc again to continue creating the PolySolid. The gaps that you may have noticed between the linear and arc segments will disappear as soon as you close the PolySolid. Notice the result. Now, there is one more useful option in PolySolid that I have not mentioned until now. Those are the alignment options. So, I will activate the PolySolid tool again to show you how to align the PolySolid to the right, to the left, and in the center of the profile you are tracing. Once I activate the PolySolid tool and before I click to define the first point, I will select the Justify option that appears in the command line. There are 3 justification options: the left, the center, and the right. The default option is the center option, which is the one that I will use in the first example. I will click on the center option and then I will click on the endpoints of the rectangle. Once I reach the last segment, I will select Close. Notice that the PolySolid is centered on the object. I will activate the tool again and click on the Justification option. From the available sub-options, I will select Left. Then, I will click on the endpoints of the rectangle, and when I reach the last segment, I will click on Close. Notice that this time the PolySolid object is aligned to the left of the rectangle's outline. Now I will activate the tool one last time to show you the last justification option. I will click on the justification option and select Right. Next, I will click on the endpoints of the rectangle again, and when I reach the last segment, I will select Close. As expected, this time the PolySolid object is aligned to the right of the rectangle's outline.